This is Marcus with Studio MMA and MMA Net, and we're here with a game bread. It was your night tonight, but it was a tough fight, and Melendez even said, he said before the fight, but after the fight, that, you know, he respects you a lot, and he says you're one of the toughest guys he's been in there with. How did you feel about the fight?
You know, I just want to look at tape, see what I did wrong, see what I did right. You know, I just got caught up trying to take him out, take his head out. You know, I wish I could have wrestled more. I'm not all American or nothing, but I could wrestle. You know, I was able to stuff his takedowns, and I got a takedown in him real quick. I just, I wish I could have fought more MMA, you know, instead of just trying to put on a boxing display. I should have gone in and stuck to the game plan a little bit more.
You showed great head movement, great footwork, and at some points you were even taunting Melendez a little bit when he was striking. Did it hurt you at all in the fight?
One punch, I don't know if it was his eye or his knuckle that got right in my right eye, and that hurt like a son of a gun, but I was good, man. I'm good. As far as like the shots to the chin or the head, I was never hurt or anything. You know, just a shot in the eye hurt me. I took a step back. I had to look at him real quick, and then I saw double, and then he came back to one. It was a good fight, man. You know, Gil's a tough dude, man.
It was a real good fight. It was a real good fight, and the crowd was really excited to see both of you go five rounds. A championship fight with five rounds. Did it concern you at all going 25 minutes?
Oh, it sure did. I mean, I'm glad I crossed this line. I've never in my life done five. Gil's done five. I can't count how many times that guy's done five rounds, you know? So that was one thing going into my mind. And that's probably what was pressing me so much for that knockout. I wanted to hurt him. And it just wasn't my night tonight, man. You know, I'm still young. I got a lot of fights under my record. I'm going to go back home with my team, American Top Team, the best team in the world. I'm going to polish up what I did wrong and beat the next five guys up that I got to do. And hopefully Gil Stout has the title and we do it again, you know?
Man, Melendez is a tough guy, but many considered the number one 155er in the world, regardless of organization, and he gave you a lot of props, respected you a lot, and said even between Strikeforce and UFC, there's a lot of guys in the UFC that he considers you one of the top 10 in the world. So I give you extra confidence hearing that from the champ.
I never really care what people think, but in this particular case, since Gil is a guy that I got a lot of respect for, definitely it helps out a lot. You know, I'm glad he said that. I don't care about rankings or nothing about what people think about me. You know, but it helps that. That Gil said that, you know, it's a cool thing of him.
We got your biggest fan behind the camera, actually, who loves you, and we look forward to seeing a lot more fights with him as well. Thank you very much.
You got it, man. I'm gonna keep training hard. I just want to thank God for everything. American Top Team, South Miami Sports Performance, Young Tigers Foundation. I'm just gonna keep coming forward, man. I'll do it, man. I'll get that world championship before 2012 ends.
You heard it here. Before 2012, we'll have a new champion in Masvidal. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.